just wanna kiss. Hello and welcome or welcome back to Actually Let's Talk About It with me, your host Lily, and today I will be reacting to Labrinth, Never Felt So Alone, the official music video featuring Billie Eilish. And I had seen it almost a week ago, and I was like, I gotta react to it, and I just didn't have time until today. So I am making time so I can react to this video because I love Labrinth. I've been a fan of him since his collaboration with Emily Sandé. Or Sandé, I'm not sure how to pronounce her last name, but it was the See Beneath Your Beautiful song. And I'm like, okay, he's been on my radar ever since. And then more recently going into the 20s, this era, 2020 through 2023, for his soundtrack skills on Euphoria, he literally makes a show, okay? Literally him. And then also Zendaya's amazing performance on the show as well. But the music, that show, the music that they be curating for that show, from the All For Us song from season one, which was him and Zendaya's collaboration, to I'm Tired in season two. I'm Tired was taking you to church. Whether you believe in that or not, that's what it was giving. I'm like, I was like, he was so hard on that song and every other song on that soundtrack for season two. Like, it was eating a little bit. I'm like, and they even got Dominic Fike on the song. I was like, okay. Anyway, but yeah, that's a whole nother thing with Dominic there, because I know he released a new music and I might get into it a little bit with that one. But yes, for right now, we're going to get into Labrinth, Never Felt So Alone, because this album is coming out soon. And I've been waiting for this album to come out, and it's been taking its sweet time, but it is coming very soon. And this is one of the songs off of it, so we're going to get straight into it and see what's good, okay? We're gonna see what's good. And this song is called, again, Never Felt So Alone. And we're gonna see what he's saying. I know it's gonna get deep here.
I never felt so alone, felt so alone, no.
Wow, what?
I never felt so alone, felt so alone.
That usually happens as you get older, because I forgot she was in her teens. She was making a good chunk of her music. And her voice changed, and it's not bad. But what they talking about here? It's a very common thing I'm hearing in that industry, where a lot of people who are artists, who are singers, who are dancers, who are actors, who are actresses, are saying that they are going through those emotions of feeling alone. I remember I was watching a clip on TikTok, and it was Jackson Wang, who is known for being in the K-pop group GOT7, and he has his own fame outside of GOT7 in terms of his solo work as well. And he was talking about the same exact thing, that he just wishes he had somebody that was there. Like he said, because he just goes home to an empty house. And I'm like, and you never think about these things with the lives that they live, the lifestyle that they live, can sometimes make it very, very difficult, because the way people view them, not the way they view themselves, but the way people view them as being these stars, when it's literally just their job. I'm like, it's just their job. They just happen to make a lot of money and have a lot of eyes on them because of it. But it's just their job at the end of the day. They're just regular people who have a talent that they market. And I'm like, yeah. So I'm feeling this, and then also knowing the depression that could come out of that, the mental health issues that could come with those emotions for too long as well. And I'm like, yeah. Or when you're around people who don't really care about you, and you can have all those people around you and feel at your lowest and at your loneliest because you know they're not for you. And I'm like, I'm feeling this. Whoa. Okay, like, dang. Yeah. So many people have spoken about this. Chloe Bailey recently as well. And I'm like, yeah. Because there's too many people speaking up about it for us not to be taking it seriously. How there's just a wonderfulness when you're on the stage because you have all the energy of all those people who came out to see you, who are your fans, who love you. But then once that energy is gone and you're just there by yourself, that's when those emotions start creeping in. And I'm like, well, yeah. Yeah. So I'm glad that they're speaking about it because it needs to be spoken about. It needs to be spoken about because people have their own coping mechanisms to deal with that loneliness. Some people do, unfortunately, some people do drugs, like some hard narcotics to distract their minds from it. Some people turn to alcohol. And those are all coping mechanisms to deal with it. And then of themselves, that's the, you know, you only know what you know. And if that's how you believe you need to handle it, because you believe that, well, it's kind of, some people have this thing where it's kind of social media, be making this much money, even though you're going through depression. And I'm out here saying I'm depressed when on the outside looking in, it looks so good. But everybody knows those can be deceiving. And the grass ain't always greener on that famous side. Okay, you gotta go through a lot of BS, a lot of dumb shit for them to be in these places that they're in. And for them to release the music they want to release, and for them to communicate with the fans that they want to communicate with the way that they want to communicate. And so it's a lot of hoops and hurdles that these artists got to go through and jump through at the hands of these record labels sometimes. And yeah, that can, that in and of itself is enough to make you feel isolated, especially when you're the main one, even though, you know, you got people you hire that, you know, be there by your side. But when you're the main one having to advocate for yourself, because nobody's going to advocate for you better than you, I'm like, And then when you get with somebody romantically, sometimes they're there for you. Sometimes they're there to leech off of you and get some fame off of you and clout off of you. And then you're like, really? You know, and I'm like, I feel that. So this song was deep. Labyrinth, there's so many different layers to this song that you could dissect and so many meanings you can get from it. But those are just the few that I got in this little reaction. I ain't gonna go into too much of a depth on it, but it was deep. And I love that Billie was in it. I'm like, it's been a minute since I've heard music from her. Not since she's released music, but since I've heard music from her. So it was cool to hear her on it a little bit. And, you know, I'm excited for Labyrinth's album. I can't wait to come out. I really can't. But yeah, that is my reaction to Labyrinth, Never Felt So Alone, with Billie Eilish there, the official music video. I thought it was deep, the way it was, kind of like he was being in the asylum, and there were all those people, and yet they were so isolated, even though they were all huddled together, they were all going through their own thing, to where it was like the presence of others wasn't really registering in their minds. And I'm like, okay, that's deep. That's deep as well, but that's like my last little analysis of it. But yes, if you like this video, don't forget to give it a good thumbs up, and also do not forget to subscribe, because again, we are on the road on this channel to 1,000 subscribers, and you know, support is kind of necessary to do that, because we are over 100 already, and then the next milestone is 200, and then 300, and you know how it goes until it gets to 1,000. But yes, and also thank you to all the patrons on Patreon. You are so appreciated, and I will continue to bring y'all some very, very new and interesting content. And if you want to check out the Patreon just to see what's going on the other side, I will link it down below so you can see and check it out and promote rooms and see if you want to become a patron. Okay? And so that is it and that is all. And I will see all of y'all in the next video. Bye.